Market capitalization, also known as market cap. I bet all of you have heard of it. But do you really understand the theory behind? Market cap gives us an indication on the value and size of the company. You may be wondering, is the market cap the large or small better? In this video, I will show you the definition of market cap and the different risk level with different market cap. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and click on the bell button for more upcoming videos. You may calculate the market cap by the following formula. By the multiplication of outstanding shares and the share price, the market cap represents the total dollar market value of a company. The total market value is defined as how much a company worth as determined by the stock market. Be aware that the market cap does not represent the true value of a company. It might be undervalued or overvalued since it is decided by the stock market. Market cap undergo changes if either the outstanding shares or the share price changes. Increasing or decreasing in number of stock or the fluctuation of the share price will change the market cap. Market cap can be divided to three different levels. Large cap in which market cap more than 10 billion. Mid cap in which market cap between 2 and 10 billion. Small cap in which market cap less than 2 billion. Different market cap consists of different risk level, and we will explain each with details. Large cap is comprised of huge company which already existed for a decade and so is a well-established company. The company has a strong and stable financial status, and normally the company gives a lot of dividend. Because of the high dividend yield and the strong financial status, this kind of stock does not move much in their share price and the risk is the lowest. Some examples are like Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Visa. All of them are well known globally and is the major player in their field. They are the leader in their respective industry. Large cap stock is not a goal for a short term trade, but definitely a win for a long term investment. Mid-cap consists of companies which are expected for rapid growth. These companies started stable and in the process of expanding their business. The expansion will definitely help the company to generate more revenues and increase their profit. This kind of company usually incurs debt and does not give much in dividend. All the money and assets will be utilized fully for their growth and expansion. Hence, the mid-cap stock has higher risk than large-cap stock. In addition, if mid-cap stock encounters some world-class crisis, they will be in trouble and end up in bankruptcy. Small-cap consists of company which is young in age. This company normally had to incur a huge debt to speed up the time in order for their company to grow at a faster rate. This helps the company to generate a great deal of profit in shorter time. Because the company incurs huge debt, this kind of stock is rather sensitive to the economic crash. Hence, small cap stock has the highest risk. If something just went wrong during the operation, they will end up in bankruptcy. But speaking the rate of return, small cap stock will definitely outperform the S&P if they have survived all the economic crises. In conclusion, market cap can be divided to three categories associated with three different risk levels. Always remember that the market cap can be undervalued or overvalued. We have to set our goal and analyze the market condition in choosing a stock. Also, not forget to understand the risk in the stock you choose. Be sure to like our video if you find this helpful, and subscribe for more upcoming investment videos.